Video and audio elements in Android Studio by The Connected.
First, we will see Android Video. For these steps, for creating the video, we will see what are the steps. First, we have to create the object for the class. Then we have to connect those objects to the elements. Then we will be able to play the video using the app. So let's see how to play a video file in Android Studio. So first of all, we have to paste the video in the folder which is present in app resources file, and in that we have to create a raw directory. If we don't find a directory, we have to create a raw directory. It will be present in the left side of our Android Studio in our project. Then this folder is the folder where we have to create our video file. First, we'll see the procedure. As I said earlier, we have to create a new object to the class in the app compact activity class. I have created two objects, which is nothing but the video view and media controller. Next, I have connected the object of the video view using the user interface, where it is given as find view by ID. This is the important step. Next, I have created the function for the play video, and I have set the media controller to get the path of the video file, which is present in the raw directory. We have used the string path android.resources. We have used the extension r.raw.trial. We have kept the video file in the raw directory. After these steps are completed, we have to play, right? Yes, let's come. We will play the video. Here, first of all, we have to set the path and URL, and we have to parse the string which we have defined above. Here, I have started the video to play.
Android Audio. Android Media Player. Android provides many ways to control playback of audio or video files and streams. One of these ways is through a class called Media Player. Android is providing a Media Player class to access the built-in Media Player services like playing audio, video, etc. In order to use this Media Player, we have to call a static method create of this class. This method returns an instance of Media Player class. The below rectangular box indicates the syntax for Android Media Player. Let's see how to play an audio file in Android Studio. The first step is, on the left-hand side of our Android Studio, make sure we are on the project sidebar and under the Android. Second step indicates, go to the app, res and raw folder. If you don't have the raw directory, then right-click on the res folder and create a new directory with raw as its name. The image indicates the raw folder where you can paste your audio file.
Once we created the raw directory, now we have to create a media file object. We can call some method to start or stop the music. So the methods are mediaplayer.start and mediaplayer.pass. On call to a start method, the music will start playing from the beginning. If this method is called again after the pass method, the music will start playing from where it left and not from the beginning. So in order to start the music from the beginning, we have to call reset method. So the syntax is mediaplayer.reset. So the methods of media player. There are many methods of media player class. So some of them are listed below. The first method is public void set data source string path. So here we can either use URL to insert the audio, or we can use the file path to insert the audio. The next method is public void prepare. It prepares the player for playback synchronously. Public void seek to. It seeks to a specified time in a millisecond. The next method is public void set volume, float left volume, float right volume. It sets the volume up on this player. Public int get duration. It returns the duration of the file.
Now we are going to see a demo for the audio and video elements. Here I have the demo for the audio element embedded in a simple Android app. Here we have two buttons, play and pause. On clicking the play button, the audio will get played, and on clicking the pause button, the audio will get paused. Here is the implementation of a video element in the Android Studio. For implementing this, first you have to create a layout file and add a video view inside it. Next, create a directory called RAW inside the RES and place the video you want to display. In the activity.java file, you have to just give the path of the video file and start the video.